Hello everyone, minasan konnichiwa. Today our subject is upper part of the body related kanji characters which are seen on the screen. Let's begin with this one. This kanji means head as part of body. Other meanings are master or mind. It consists of two parts. These two parts are also different kanji characters. First part, which looks like a pot on an oven, is bean kanji. Think that beans is cooked in the pot. For the second part, let's look at the shellfish. Red one is small shellfish, but blue or dark green one is big shellfish, in other words, head shellfish. So the second part of the kanji means head in English. When we bring them together, then we obtain head kanji. Think that a dish of beans is cooked on the oven and head shellfish tastes beans first. So when we see this kanji somewhere, we may remember this dark blue head shellfish tasting beans. About the readings of this kanji, on one side Mr. Bean to symbolize the bean part and on the other side the head shellfish to symbolize the head part may have a conversation between each other. As you see, there is a dish of beans there, and both Mr. Bean and the head shellfish want to eat it. Mr. Bean warns, saying, "I am the head here, so that dish is mine. Make your eyes zoom out." Here, both written syllables in the words ata and mine give us the kun reading, which is atama, and to, part of the past form of the verb tell, and zu, from the verb zoom, are the on readings of these kanji. Now let's take a look at its stroke order and some examples containing this kanji. We have three examples. First, atama, meaning head or mind. Second, tobu, meaning head as part of body. And third, tutsu, meaning headache. Please check the given examples and try to see related words. Now let's move on to the second kanji of today. The meaning of this kanji is face. It consists of two parts. For the first part, please look at the left-hand side of the screen. There is a bald drummer standing there, dreaming of himself to have hair on his head. Below there is cliff radical, and at the bottom there is hair or hairstyle symbolizing radical. When three of them combine, then we get the left part of here introduced kanji character. For the second part, please remember the head radical from the head shellfish figure. So when we see this kanji, we can imagine a bald drummer standing near the cliff, wishing a trendy hairstyle. But on the other hand, without hair, his face looks brighter. In short, standing drummer's bright face and head with no hair give us the meaning of this kanji, which is face. About the readings, let's hear what this drummer says. He says, maybe it's better with no cover of hair or beard on face. When all hair is gone, I feel my view widened. Here kun reading kao sounds like bold written word cover, and on reading gun can be remembered from the second bold written word gun, which is also past participle of the verb go. Now let's take a look at the stroke order and examples. First example word is egao, which means smiling face or smile. Second word is kaoiru, meaning complexion. And third word is sengan, meaning face washing. Please check these words in given example sentences before going ahead. Now let's review first two kanji pair of today. First kanji means head. Please remember head of the shellfish family tasting beans. Kun reading is atama. Remember, Mr. Bean utters and says it's mine for the beans dish. The words ata and syllable my from the word mine give us the kun reading. First on reading is to. Remember from Mr. Bean saying I have told you expression. Other on reading is zu. Remember from make your eyes zoom out expression. Second kanji is face kanji. Remember standing drummer's bright face. Cool reading is cow, remember from the word cover. And on reading is gun, remember from when all gone expression. Okay, now the third kanji. This kanji means neck in English. Here we have two similar shapes, head shellfish and giraffe. Head shellfish is a figure for head radical, but not for neck. For neck, two legs at the bottom move to the top, like the figure of giraffe. A giraffe figure looks like a reminder for a head with long neck. So when we see this kanji figure, we can remember a giraffe's head with long neck. For the readings of neck kanji, let's look at the script. In there, Scooby-Doo compares itself with giraffe in terms of height and says, we choose, maybe it looks taller. Here, Kubi from the name Scooby-Doo is the kun reading and shu or shu from the word choose is the on reading of this kanji. Now the stroke order and examples. We have three examples. First, Kubi meaning neck. Second, Shuto meaning capital city or metropolis. And third, Kubi ni naru meaning to be fired from a job. Again, please check given sentences here to see the usages of these words. Now the last kanji for today. This kanji means hair or fur in English. It is similar to hand kanji. In hand kanji, hand figure has a hook towards left. But in hair kanji, the direction of the perpendicular hook is towards right. To differentiate which is which, think that in shown arm of a person, hair area like hair itself, beard or mustache exists towards right. So if the hook is towards right, then we understand that it shows hair part and the kanji means hair. About its readings, let's hear what these two men are talking about. The man with no beard says to the other, you should take good care of your long hair and beard, or you can turn into a caveman and become mournful about it. Here first bold written syllable K, part of the word K is the kun reading, and second bold written syllable mo or mo from the word mournful is the on reading of this kanji. Now let's see the stroke order and examples. Our first example is K, meaning hair itself. Second one is mofu, meaning blanket. And the third one is keito, meaning wool or woolen yarn. Don't forget to check them in given sentences. Now the review section. Let's remember last two kanji figures. Third kanji is neck kanji. Remember the head of giraffe with long neck. Its kun reading is kubi. Remember from Scooby-Doo. And the on reading is shu or shu. Remember the shoes Scooby-Doo tries to wear in order to show itself taller. The last kanji is hair kanji or fur kanji. Remember perpendicular hook looks towards right of the right arm to reach hair part. Its kun reading is ke. Remember from care of hair expression. And on reading is mo or mo. Remember from mournful expression. Okay guys, that's all for today. Details and more can be reached at the website kanjimaya.com. Today's kanji characters are at kanji menu. Go to the nature and people submenu and click on day 25 and 26 links under grade 2 title. So keep following. Kondo no video, mata aimashou. Genki de, sayonara.